Okay, it's in the Bogan arm now, and I'm trying to track with the arm sort of semi-rigid.
Pretty good job, Jeff.
And this is at full zoom.
Yes, we can see the suggestion of the tether on the right side, unless that's just a reflection on the window panes.
Yeah, I could definitely see the tether in the viewfinder. Unfortunately, it was at a low angle through the window, and so there's a lot of distortion in the image.
Copy.
We have acquisition out the front window. I'm going to go and take some more pictures of that.
Roger.
Okay, here's the last little bit I got through the front window. It's not very good. It was very low, and the window's pretty dirty. And it was hard to get access, but I might as well downlink it. It's about 2.5 minutes worth.
Thank you, Jeff.
Okay, Houston, we got contact. It's beautiful. We're going to get it on the TVs and downlink to you. We can see the tether.
Great news, Franklin, and we'll look for that picture. Franklin, we see a long line, a couple of star-like things, and a lot of things swimming in the foreground. Can you describe what you're seeing?
Well, the long line is a tether, and there's a little bit of debris that kind of flies with us, and it's illuminated by the sun at such low angle. So there's a lot of stray light, and it's getting washed out quickly, but Claude is trying to do a good job here adjusting the cameras.
Copy that.
Houston, Columbia, I was using both the 20 power binoculars and the 400mm Nikon lens under the body bag, and it only just disappeared in the glare of the sun about 30 seconds ago. The tether looked completely straight. I did not see any bright spots along the tether except at the very bottom where there was a bright spot which was unresolvable. For me, I did not see anything above the satellite.
Thank you. We copy all, Jeff. Good observations. We look forward to your descriptions and photography when you get back.
Go ahead, Houston.
Andy, during the last mile in Bermuda passes, the signal was coming in and out. It was getting pretty weak, so our analysis indicates that the battery's just about done all it can.
Okay, well, I'm impressed that it stayed in there as long as it did. That's great.
Yeah, it's pretty impressive little spacecraft. We were kind of tickled to be able to get so much data out of it out there flying along.
And that's pretty bright object. We've had some good viewings of it up here in the last evening.
Well, we're gleefully rubbing our hands together, anticipating getting some sightings over Houston a few days from now.
Sounds great.
And we're ready, Mauricio.